queridos oyentes de Nuestras Voces. Estamos aquí para presentarles un programa, una noche más, un programa bien interesante. Y vamos a empezar bien rapidito para poder ser eficientes con nuestro tiempo. Vamos a empezar hablando con el oficial Croze, que representa al Departamento de Policía, que trabaja junto con el Centro de Alcance Hispano llamado Hispanic Outreach Center en Clearwater. Entonces, el oficial está aquí para hablar con nosotros de un tema bien escabroso y bien interesante para la comunidad, y es el tema de tráfico humano y también tráfico de estupefacientes. Todos los oyentes están invitados a participar en esta entrevista. Nuestros números de teléfono aquí en el aire, en la emisora, son 727-441-3000, y si llaman fuera del área pueden llamar a 1-866-826-1340, 1-866-826-1340. Y ya sin más retraso vamos a introducir a nuestro invitado. Vamos a tener esta entrevista en inglés, no va a haber ningún problema, todo el mundo puede entenderlo. Y si necesitan preguntar cosas personales, siempre pueden contactarme en la página del Facebook María Bengono, o también ir a la página de Nuestras Voces, que es el nombre del show, en Facebook, y ver la retransmisión de este video, al igual que también enviar vuestras preguntas. Bueno. Good night. Thank you so much for being here, Officer Croze.
You're welcome.
It is a pleasure to have you. We really, really enjoy that you are joining us to give information that is very useful for the community, for everybody that is listening to the show in the Tampa Bay area. So, good night. Thank you for coming here, and let's go ahead with the information that we are going to give out to the community. First of all, give us the location of the Hispanic Outreach Center, as well as your position and responsibilities in that office.
Okay. Well, first of all, the Hispanic Outreach Center is here in Clearwater. And I'd like to say we are very proud that it is the only Hispanic Outreach Center in the Tampa Bay area, in the Clearwater Police Department. Is the only police department in the Tampa Bay area that has a Hispanic outreach officer and has such a close relationship with a Hispanic outreach center, and makes it a priority to serve the Hispanic community. So that is my main function. I'm the Hispanic outreach officer. Mm-hmm. My main role is to deal with issues within the Hispanic community. Mm-hmm. Even though I am not yet fluent in Spanish, estoy aprendiendo español. I'm working on it.
You're doing an excellent job.
Thank you.
I know you are doing a great job.
So the address of the HOC is 612 Franklin Street, 612 Care Franklin. The phone number is 727-445-9734-727-445-9734. So if you need to contact us, come down to 612 Franklin Street or give us a phone call.
That's very good. And for those people that they didn't have the opportunity to take either the address or the phone number, don't worry, because we're going to keep repeating this information during the show. Okay, so we want to thank you again, me and probably all the listeners, for this excellent job and this cooperation that the Hispanic Outreach Center and the Police Department in Clearwater is doing, because it's beneficial for the whole community, and especially is letting the Hispanic community know that the police officers are here to help and to answer their questions, and definitely get as much information about the services that you guys provide. Is going to be great for everybody in this community. So let's go ahead. Tell me about human trafficking in the Tampa Bay area in Clearwater.
Okay. There is an issue with human trafficking here in the Tampa Bay area, so much where there is a human trafficking task force. And we at the Clearwater Police Department have detectives assigned to that task force. Now, human trafficking can involve either someone that's being forced to get into the sex slave trade, prostitution, things like that, forced labor, where they're either being forced to work for no wages, mm-hmm. Or very little wages, or debt, servitude. Basically, what that involves is if somebody wants to come to this country, mm-hmm. They are told that they will be helped into this country, but they have to pay back a debt to that person that gets them into the country. So basically, they become servants or slaves, pretty much, mm-hmm. For free.
Right. You
know, they'll work or they'll do something for no pay. Mm-hmm. Basically paying back the debt that they owe this person.
Mm-hmm.
This is highly illegal, and it is happening here in the Tampa Bay area.
Well, give us a little bit of information about what section of the community get more affected. I know that people normally talk about immigrants that come from Asia as well as immigrants that come from Hispanic countries. Mm-hmm. What other sections of the community are you see that are affected the most for this kind of trafficking?
Well, the cases I've seen through the Clearwater Police Department, it runs the gamut of different races and mm-hmm. nationalities. We've seen in the Asian community, we've seen it in the Mexican and the Hispanic community. I personally have seen it more with the Mexican community,
mm-hmm.
Where somebody maybe wants to come to this country mm-hmm. from Mexico. They are told by somebody in Mexico that, hey, I can get you to America. Just do what I say, come with me, or follow this person, go with this person that I know. And they end up being pretty much traded, forced into, say, prostitution.
And it's really sad. There are many movies going on these days mm-hmm. Trying to expose these kind of situations, and there are many celebrities that are fighting in daily basics to avoid situations like this to happen. We are trying to let the audience know that there is no way for you to trust somebody that says that is getting paid money to bring you to a place where you're gonna get a better life.
Right.
Because unfortunately, I believe that this will turn into an industry where there are no limits, and then something that probably you start doing thinking that is gonna be a better opportunity for you and your family can turn into many people abusing that situation and turning it into stealing kids or mm-hmm. wife or men or women or children, you know, to use them and abuse them as exchange for money. Mm-hmm. You know, actually, there are many situations where they take pictures of the things that they do, and then they put it on Facebook, and there is a lot of money on it. So mm-hmm. trusting somebody, paying somebody that says that is going to help you out to move your family from one country to another probably is not the best option. What areas in Clearwater, Pinellas County, or the Bay Area you have seen these situations happening the most?
We've seen it all through the city here in Clearwater. There was one case that we had that was out in the eastern part of the city, countryside, where there was forced labor, where individuals were being forced to work in a restaurant for little or no pay. And we've seen it on the west side of our city, where there was forced prostitution. Now, I say forced. The individuals that are doing the trafficking will often use physical abuse, mental abuse, and pretty brutal at times. Isolation, they won't allow this person to go out. The trafficker will control all their money. So we've seen it all through the city.
Now, let's say in the hypothetical case, let's say that somebody made the mistake or the bad choice of paying somebody else money to mm-hmm. bring their family into their country, you know, to have better opportunities, and they didn't get to see their family once they got here. What that person can do?
They need to contact the authorities right away.
Mm-hmm.
If it's within the Tampa Bay area, they could contact the Clearwater Police Department.
Mm-hmm.
As I stated, we have detectives who are specifically assigned to deal with human trafficking.
Mm-hmm.
Tell our detectives what's going on, and then they can start an investigation from there.
Mm-hmm.
But they need to report it right away.
Definitely. And then what happened with the legal status of the person that is reporting the case?
As far as I know, their legal status, they're not going to be deported. Mm-hmm. They are a victim at this point. Mm-hmm. And what could happen is they could apply for what's called a T visa, mm-hmm. which T stands for trafficking. They are the victim of a crime. They could apply for the T visa. If they are granted the T visa, they will have residency status in the United States for, I believe that visa is good for 3 years. Mm-hmm. So they're not going to be kicked out. They're actually going to be helped to become to get a residency status in the United States.
What happened if that family, while they are here trying to solve the crime, they get messages as, well, if you go ahead with this investigation, your family back in your town is going to be in trouble, or what do they do?
Again, report that right away, and then it can be handled. They can't just ignore it and stop the investigation. Mm-hmm. They obviously want to see their family again, mm-hmm. But they need to report that also if they're getting threats.
Mm-hmm. So, in the case where you are working in a place, location, a restaurant or whatever it is, and you know that your coworkers or your boss mm-hmm. have people working there, they are in this situation where you don't fully know what's going on, but it feels like they are not being paid or treated fairly, or mm-hmm. they look like they don't sleep enough. What do you do? Do you report it? What can you do?
Again, report it, especially here in Clearwater. Come to the Clearwater Police Department and report it to us. Mm-hmm. Do not ignore it, because sometimes you have that, you know, that gut feeling, that feeling that something's going on. Hmm. You could be right. And this, the employer could be forcing them pretty much to do slave labor. So it's very important that we know about it, we can investigate it, and help these victims.
And what happens if you go to a restaurant and you see that you leave a tip, and then probably you see that the boss or the manager is keeping the tip, and you just feel like, oh, the employee is not have, you know, is not having the opportunity to take a break, and they are working like crazy. You, mm-hmm. as a customer, also have the responsibility to go and report that situation?
Yes. If you feel there's unfair labor practices going on, you need to report it right away. It may not be a situation that it's human trafficking. Mm-hmm. It could just be unfair labor practices, but it could be human trafficking. It mm-hmm. could be something more serious, and we need to know that right away.
So when somebody go is going to report a situation like that, but they are concerned about, I don't want to be involved in anything. I don't want my mm-hmm. name there. I have families. I don't want my children to go through this process. I don't know what is ahead of me. I don't want to get involved. What could you tell people that feel that way?
Well, first of all, I always try to tell people, put yourself in the victim's shoes. What mm-hmm. if that was you? What if that was your family and they were being forced into either prostitution or slave labor? You would want them to get help. Mm-hmm. So it's incumbent upon them to help get this person help. And when they initially report a crime, we don't go to the perpetrator and say, hey, this person is the one that reported it. We don't tell them who reported it. We investigate it and then take it from there. But we don't let them know who reported it. Now, down the line, their name may come up for a criminal case, you know, in court. But initially, their name is not brought up. So,
okay. So I'm pretty sure that many people feel like, okay, well, if this goes to court and I have to testify as a witness, mm-hmm. I don't want to be on TV. I don't want to be in the newspapers. Right. I don't want to have to be exposed. Is there any way for them to be protected against all that publicity?
And they may not. It may not be a situation where they're going to have to go to court, especially if they're just initially reporting it, mm-hmm. saying, hey, I think there's something suspicious here. Mm-hmm. But if they have to go to court, yeah, you know, you could sit down and speak with the state attorney and say, hey, this is my feelings. I don't want my face out there, things like that. And mm-hmm. many times their face is not put out there. Their name's not put out there. It's mm-hmm. a closed situation in court. So I would tell them not to worry about that.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. So what we want to know is, as the community, what can we do if we see somebody that is probably treating somebody else wrong? Mm-hmm. Or we see somebody either in a business place or on the street that doesn't look like he knows where it is, where he is or she is, mm-hmm. or they feel like confused, and you just have the feeling that these people are being forced to do something that they don't really want to do. So basically, we just have to go ahead, decide to contact the authorities and yes. give the information. Maybe that we are right in our feelings, but maybe that we are wrong. But we definitely have to go there and report it. That is going to help the community, the city, to be more safe, eliminate that kind of crime in Clearwater and Tampa Bay area, right?
Yes.
Okay, so let's give us the contact information of the Hispanic Outreach Center again, as well as the phone numbers and the hours of operation, so people that have these situations can go ahead and contact you guys.
Okay. Again, my name is Officer Croze, Oficial Croze. The address of the Hispanic Outreach Center is 612 Franklin Street, 612 Calle de Franklin. The phone number is 727-445-9734-727-445-9734.
Good. Thank you so much. So let's go ahead and give us, what is it that you want us to take from this interview?
The biggest thing I want you to take, in the audience to take, is again to let you know that we, as the Clearwater Police Department, are here for the community, for the Hispanic community. It is very important that if you see or feel someone is the victim of human trafficking, that they are being forced into what we call slave labor, working for little or no wages, working constant, unrealistic hours, 7 days a week, no breaks, or you feel that someone's being forced into prostitution, and you see signs of that, you know, this person maybe has signs of physical abuse, they seem isolated. They never go anywhere alone. They never have any money. It seems like their money is controlled. All these signs, to report it right away. It is very important. It's very important that we look out for each other, especially within the Hispanic community. Sometimes within your community, each other is all you have. And you can tell when something is not right within your community and where you are. So it is very important to report what's going on. Please do not worry about your residency status if you are undocumented. As I stated before, that's not important to us. What's important to us is that there's a victim of a crime out there, and they may need some help. And this may be something very serious that's going on. So it is very, very important to get involved, look out for each other, and to report these crimes.
And that's very good. The Hispanic Outreach Center also have social workers and have other employees that are going to help through the process. Mm-hmm. When somebody is coming to report the situation that they have seen, or they are coming to report the situation that they are experiencing themselves, you don't have to worry about if you don't speak English. Because no. There are people there that speak English. The officer speak very good Spanish. The people that works there speak Spanish too. Then he have a translator. I mean, there is a big group of people in that center that are there just to help you.
Yes.
You know, to take over your report and pass it forward to whatever person have to take care of it. Mm-hmm. Process all the documentation and study investigation as, you know, supposed to be. Also, the Hispanic Outreach Center have other services like psychological services, mm-hmm. and then they can refer you to places where they can help you out further, yes. With food.
Yep, legal services. Mm-hmm. They are work very closely with Gulf Coast Legal Services, mm-hmm. which is pro bono, usually free legal mm-hmm. services. So they can help you get any legal help that you may need also.
That's good. And it's very important that you mention that because all these services are going to be free of charge.
Yes. There is no fee.
Because the Hispanic Outreach Center is a nonprofit organization, correct. Which means that they don't get paid for the services that they offer. And they have a big network of referrals to assist the community in different cases. The other point that we are trying to bring out through our interviews with the Officer Croze is that the police department in Clearwater is trying to send out the message that they are here to listen, to help, and to assist with questions and troubles so that the people that live in this city feel more safe. Mm-hmm. They trying to be closer to the community.
Yes.
We are very grateful that they have somebody designated especially for the Hispanic community in this center mm-hmm. that is there to listen to whoever goes there and needs help.
Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely. And even if they don't live in the city of Clearwater, they could still come to the center for help, and then, you know, we can take it from there. If it's a criminal investigation that needs to be done and it didn't happen in Clearwater, I could still refer it to that specific agency. Mm-hmm. But even if you live outside of Clearwater, you can come to the Hispanic Outreach Center.
Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit, how long have you been working with them?
I've been at the center now for approximately 1 year. Mm-hmm. I've been a police officer in Clearwater for 3 years, and I have over 16 years experience as a police officer.
And what was your motivation to work with this organization?
I saw it as an excellent opportunity to do some good in the community mm-hmm. and help out people that need some help. Mm-hmm. So that's why I accepted the position.
And additional to this case that we are talking about today, what other cases do you encounter in your daily basics?
All different types of cases. I've dealt with domestic abuse cases, neighbor disputes, things like that. I had not really a case, but I assisted a mother several weeks ago. She came to the Hispanic Outreach Center very upset, on the verge of tears. She thought she found a gun in her son's bedroom. And she thought it was a real gun. It turns out it was a paintball gun, which is great. You know, it was just a paintball gun. But we were glad that she had the knowledge to come to the center to seek me out and say, I need some help. I think my son has a gun. Luckily, it was just a paintball gun. But I've dealt with situations like that. So it, all types of different situations. And again, I work with the HOC, you know, as a team. Mm-hmm. So it's a great partnership that we have.
What is it people say after they have experienced your services and they have received your help?
They're usually relieved because, again, there's that initial fear that if they're an undocumented person that I'm going to deport them or start the deportation proceedings. And they're very relieved and realize that's not what I do. But they're very thankful. And again, it's not just me, it's the staff at the HOC also, and my fellow officers. Many times I have to call upon their help for things. So it's not just me, it's a whole team of people between myself, the staff at the HOC, and my fellow officers. It's a team effort.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome.
And what is the normal process? Like somebody have a situation that they want to report, they just go to the Hispanic Outreach Center and they ask for you straightforward, or they just go and talk to the people that works there first?
They could ask for me if they want to speak to me directly. Mm-hmm. And if I'm there, I'll come right out and help them. If I'm not there, usually the staff will call me and I'll respond there. Or if it's a situation where I can't respond, the staff there can take the information down, and then we'll take it from there.
Okay. So, yes, we have a few more minutes before this session is over, and mm-hmm. I want to thank you now, in case we don't have time later, for being here and for sharing the information that this information that is so valuable for all the community, and working with my program, Nuestras Voces, to give, you know, this information out. But before we finish, I want to ask you, why is it that you guys, as the police department, consider this as a very important situation? Do you think it's happening now lately more than before, or is just you just wanna end that with it because it was very strong before and you are just picking up the pieces? Or why is it that you consider this such so important?
Is that the human trafficking mm-hmm. you're talking about? It's very important because it's a very serious crime. As far as I know, the Clearwater Police Department has been working on this for quite a while. It's nothing new. We've had detectives assigned to deal with this for quite a while. It's something that we feel is very important, that needs to be looked at, investigated, and get these victims the help that they need. Because not only is it an issue in Clearwater, it's a nationwide issue, and it's actually a worldwide issue. It's happening worldwide. And what we can do with the Clearwater Police Department is just help the victims in this area and whatever we can do. So we feel it's very important. It's a very serious crime. And we look at it very seriously, and we just want to get these victims the help they need.
Definitely. If all the community works together and we give out the information, mm-hmm. at least our area is going to be more safe than others.
Yes.
We can reduce the trafficking around here. We can have our kids and our family members more safe. And definitely, probably, we can make better choices mm-hmm. when we are considering ways of having a better future for ourselves and our family. Definitely considering paying somebody to bring our family here out to other country is not the best choice.
No, you have to be very, very careful. And if it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. You know, there's that saying, if someone tells you, I can get your family here mm-hmm. For this amount of money, just trust me, you need to be very careful with that.
Right, it is dangerous. And we have a call. Do we have a call? Okay, so we're going to go ahead and I want to thank you one more time, and we're going to give out the information of the offices again for the audience in case they didn't have time to write it down, and yes. then they can contact you guys as they need.
Yes. Okay, again, the address for the Hispanic Outreach Center is 612 Franklin Street, 612 Calle de Franklin. The phone number is 727-445-9734-727-445-9734.
Thank you so much. And this is going to be the end of our program right now. And we are going to come back next week with another subject that is very helpful to the community. And Officer Croze is going to be here giving us information and helping the community as he has been doing these 2 weeks. Thank you so much for being here.
You're very welcome.
Not only your assistance, but also the department, the police department of Clearwater, for helping us.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Okay. Good night.
Good night.
WTAN Clearwater, Tampa Bay. WDCF Dade City, Tampa Bay. WZHR Zephyr Hills, Tampa Bay. Listen.